Hello everybody, Domestic Fox here with another furry knife review, and today we'll be reviewing this guy. This right here, little guy, is the CRKT Pilar. This is a Jesper Voxnes design, which if you follow his work, he makes some pretty cool knives. This is a pretty old CRKT knife, but it's my turn to review it, so I'm going to review it anyway. Keep in mind that this one is the Blade HQ exclusive version with the JG10 handle scale. The other side is steel. The blade is D2 steel, but that's only for the Blade XQ exclusive version. The regular version is 8CR 13 MOV. This knife sports a nice sheep's foot, flat ground, stonewash finished blade. And I mean, just look at that. I'm going to show you a close-up pretty soon, so stay tuned for that. This guy is made in China, which is typical for a CRKT, but fit and finish on it is actually not too bad. I will be showing you a close-up and measurements, weight, all that kind of stuff up in a minute here. Keep in mind that this is the Blade HQ exclusive version. There are other versions out there with different handle materials or handle colors. The regular version has 8CR 13 MOV blade, like I said. And there are different finishes on the blade as well. They do make another model, which is the PLR Large. That one has a flipper tab. This one does not have a flipper tab. This one has only a blade hole. They do have a PLR 2 out there as well, which a lot of people say is better than this one. I yet to try out the next one. And they also have a PLR 2 with a clip point blade coming out as well, if it's not already out. I can't remember if it's out or coming out. But either way, there is one with a clip point blade, which is cool. Now, price on this guy, this is the Blade HQ exclusive version, like I keep saying, which this particular model is $31.99. The price on the regular model is $35.95. The price on the model does vary depending on the handle materials that you pick and the color and the blade finish. So keep that in mind. This is not the only price. They have a bunch of other versions and the prices vary from version to version. On CRKT's website, it's $39, so almost a $40 knife, but that one has 8CR 13 MOV blade steel. So, you can also get the regular version on Amazon for $38. And the price on Knife Center is $37.95. So of all those dealers, Blade HQ has the best deal. All right, I'm going to take you on over to Human Hands real quick to show you the measurements and weight, and then you'll be back with me, and I'm going to ramble some more about my personal opinions. Welcome back. The ergos on this guy feels really good, very comfortable in the paw, especially with that choil that it has. It allows you to get a lot of control over that blade so you can do some fine work with the tip and stuff like that. I'm not sure you're going to be able to see it from here, but you probably already saw it from human hands. The pocket clip on this guy is not very intrusive. It doesn't feel too uncomfortable in my paws. It does come out of the box tip down carry. You can reverse it to tip up carry. It's right hand carry only. But unfortunately, I don't know what CRKT does with their stinking screws. They put them in so tight, they use some like serious Loctite. And I keep stripping their screws. So now this knife is stuck in tip-down carry. I can't get those screws out. It's really annoying. Every time I work on a CRKT knife, I end up stripping the screw or stripping my bit. It's irritating. Now, I'm not sure if you noticed from the close-up from human hands that this knife has an extremely thick blade geometry. The spine on it is actually quite thick for a knife of this size. It's a very small knife. It should be a bit thinner, in my opinion, to really slice through material. As you saw, it did cut through paper with ease. It was actually surprisingly sharp. I can assume that it's probably less so with the ACR 13 MOV version. D2 has always felt really nice to me. I love D2. I'm going to keep saying that. But if you're cutting through like cardboard, the more thickness you have on your knife, the more drag you have cutting through tougher materials or thicker materials. So it will slow down your cuts and make it a little bit less efficient. So I don't know why they made this knife so thick back there. It doesn't serve any purpose, really. It's already a decently tough steel, D2 is. But what do I know? I'm just a fox. One of my other gripes with this knife is the lock. I don't like steel frame locks. They're just so stinking tight. It hurts my hand. If you saw, I was struggling to open and close this knife. And when I disengage this lock, it literally rubs my fingers raw. It hurts over time. I cannot fidget with this knife. And I prefer actually using two-hand open and close on this knife. Well, actually, two-hand close is more accurate. I do one-hand open this knife. But I use two hands to close it because that frame lock is so stinking tight. Out of the box, it was nearly impossible to disengage this knife. I had to put some serious pressure into it. Working it in, it still hurts. I can't do it one-handed, but it hurts over time. And it's just very uncomfortable, not very functional. A knife that hurts the user, that's not a good thing. Not in the slightest. So that's one of my gripes, is I don't like steel frame locks. They're too hard to disengage. Unlike titanium frame locks. Titanium frame locks are great. They're tough, they're durable, and they disengage beautifully, especially if they have a nice steel insert to keep it from wearing out faster. I'm not a fan of steel frame locks. They just don't work for me. They're very uncomfortable, and they require way too much force to disengage. Now, that might just be because I'm a fidget enthusiast when it comes to my knives. I like my knives to open and disengage easy and fun, fast, just stuff like that. It still will work, but you're just going to have to compensate for this lock that is extremely tight. And then the disengagement is also slow. The deployment is not bad at all. It opens up really nice. You can access that hole really easily with your thumb or your index finger and open it up really nicely. It's really good. I really like that hole. This knife, the way how the handle is shaped, it looks like it would have a flipper. Every time I see this knife, I'm like, I think it's going to have a flipper. It doesn't. It's only the P-large, or P-lar large. It should have been a P-large. This guy does have a lanyard hole on the back, which is okay. I can take it or leave it. It's right next to the tip up carry pocket clip spot, so it is a little bit higher. But they're pretty much side by side, so it's not too much of a big deal for me. And so that's it. That's my opinion on this knife. Do I recommend it? No, for around 40 or so bucks, 30, give or take, depending on where you buy this knife and what model you get. Depending on what blade materials you get, handle materials, there are some in micarta. You can get also aftermarket scales for this from like Flightanium. Blade HQ also sells quite a bit of those as well. There's one with copper scale as well. So the price will vary depending on what model you get. I can't recommend this knife. You can spend your money on a much more efficient knife that won't cost you so much thumb energy to disengage and open it. That's just my opinion. I know this knife is pretty popular, and I'm okay with it. I would use it occasionally, but it's not something I seek out to carry because of how uncomfortable it is to disengage. So I do want to try out the Pilar 2 because I hear that one, Pilar 2, because I hear that one is much, much more of an improvement. I can't complain too much because it did have a nice edge on it. The fit and finish is actually not bad at all. It's comfortable to use. It's just uncomfortable to disengage. That's pretty much it. It's just not the most easy to manipulate knife out there. There are definitely better knives for better prices that are easier to manipulate. That's just my opinion. Feel free to share your opinion in the comments and complain and tell me how wrong I am. But having said that, I'm glad to have it. It's nice. It's just in my collection and I will use it occasionally, but that's just my opinion and my honest review. Well, I think that'll be it for this video. I hope you like this video. If you like more knife and EDC related content, go check out my other videos. And remember to subscribe because I post every Saturday, every other Sunday, and there'll be more knives and more videos in the future. Thank you so much for watching, and have a fantastic day. Bye!